My name is Szymon Kłos, and I'm a software engineer contracted by Collabora Productivity. I wanted to talk about tools around the online which can help you while developing. I will show you a small but very useful app called GTK Tiled Viewer. Then I will show you how you can debug app using Chrome browser and how to do the same on the real mobile device. Then we'll talk about how to debug some integrations like mobile apps with WebView, which embedded online, and about two other tools called Browser Sync, which can help you change the code faster, and Linter, which can help you with compatibility of the code. First thing, you probably know GDB, as most of us are C++ developers. And then when you can debug some backend code, the core, in online mode, which is used while tiled rendering, and then in the online, you can use this small app, which is just another client, but not written in JavaScript. It's just a C++ app which uses GTK. You can attach GDB as to a normal application, so it's the command you can use. You have to specify the path to your LibreOffice instance and to file you want to open. As you can see on the screenshot, there are some simple tools to modify the document, the font, or for zooming. You can also click the button where you can specify any command you want to test. But when the issue is not in the backend, in the core, you need to somehow debug the JavaScript code. So the most advanced, in my opinion, is Chrome Inspector, which can show you a lot of things. You can debug the code like in normal IDE and see the printing on the console. You can test, you can see which requests take most of the time, and you can also connect to another devices like Android phones. There are a few tabs where you can see that's data. Here is the real example. In one tab, we can debug the HTML. We can modify some DOM elements in this tab. In second one, there is a console, so when we log something, we can see it here. Another tab is the Source Explorer, so it works like normal code editor, where we can put some modification. We can also, in case of JavaScript code, put breakpoints and see the call stack and everything like in normal IDE. And what I said, when we want to profile the application and check what we can improve, what files are take a lot of time to load, we can use this network viewer where we can see the size of requests, status, and the time, also the order. in case we send some request and it fails, we see the status. And in the bottom, we can see the devices tab, where when we connect the phone, we can see its name and opened Chrome or WebView applications. It looks like this. Here we see the name of a phone, the application with WebView. In this case, it was just a browser, and the URL. We can open new tabs or inspect already existing. So it's very useful because we can also use the mouse to modify something here, so we don't need to take our phone and manually try to click on some small elements. We can use the mouse on bigger screen. Another thing useful in this inspector is that we can switch the mode, and we can see how how the app will look when we test it on a smaller screen. We can choose some types of phones or tablets here. Okay. You have to trust me. Yes. Okay. But to have the possibility to use your mobile device, you will need to enable the debug mode. In case of Android over version 4 and 2, you need to open the settings and tap a few times on the build number in About. After seven taps, you will see new option. It's the developer options label. And inside, you can check the USB debugging. Then you will be able to debug apps on your phone. And also, you will be able to install some custom applications you will write in Android Studio. But to the second thing, you will also need some fix if you use Linux, because you need to add UDEF rules. And you can do this on your own, checking the vendor and product ID numbers for your USB device, but it's easier to get the ready config from GitHub. I put the link here. It's a database with popular devices, so all phones should work. Next step, integrations. When we integrate online in some web apps, then it's enough to use Inspector in the browser. But what when we have the native Android application and the web view? Then you can also use Chrome, but to do this, you need to build of the application with WebView debugging active. So in the code, in native app, you need to put something like this to enable it, and then you will see here the name of your application and possibility to inspect that content. Another tool I wanted to show you is Browser Sync. I integrated this on during the Hack Week sponsored by Collabora Productivity. It was annoying to restart the server every time when I made some, even a small change, when I wanted to be sure that everything is fine, because I had to close the server, restart it, wait for or checking for some unit tests sometimes, and then open again the browser, open the same state, for example, some window, and then I was able to check something. But this tool, there is another partial solution. We can use the Chrome Inspector and modify the CSS there or some properties of one node. But then we have to remember that we need to copy that to the source code. So it's easy to forget something, and sometimes we not see the whole thing because something is changing in the time. So better option is Browser Sync, which can automatically reload the content you see on in the browser when it detects the source code change. I prepared a video where you can see how it works. We need to run the server with a special parameter to serve files directly from the disk, not from any cache. And then we can run Browser Sync proxy. Then when we modify the code, in this case it's CSS, we will see the effect just after saving the file. In the console, we see if there was some change. It also works with JavaScript, but then Browser Sync will reload whole application, not only that part. But it's still faster than doing this manually. So how it works? Browser Sync can work in two modes. It can be standalone server and serve some files from directory, or set up a proxy. So I used the proxy. And it's in the browser we open just another application on another port. In this case, it's 3000. And the Browser Sync in the background checks all the time if some files are updated. And in that case, it fires some refresh event to some JavaScript, which is served on the proxied application. So it can reload part of whole window. To integrate this into online, I needed to add some change to make files, because before we copied source files from original files to the destination directory where files are served, but it doesn't work because when you modify some something in original file, then it doesn't detect that change because it's another file than that one which is served. And if we modify something in this destination directory, then it's not tracked by a git. So we cannot commit that easily. We could, of course, copy the file, but it's not a good solution. So I modified the make file to make symbolic link to the original files instead of copying, in case we enable browser sync. To enable it, we need to add enable browser sync switch during the configuration of a project. And what's important, if we already built previously the application, we need to do make clean to be sure that no file is in the destination directory. After configuration, we see the summary where we can check if browser sync is really enabled. And we can see additional make target with sync writer or calc impress, which starts the proxy with the application we typed. Of course, we need two consoles, one with the server, so we just do make run, and another one with this proxy, with make sync writer, for example. The next tool, it was already in the project for a long time, linter slint, but it checks mostly the code formatting, I think, and I noticed a few times that we had some functions in the code which doesn't work in some browsers, like Internet Explorer 11. And this causes some bugs on that platform. So to prevent that mistakes, I proposed a patch on Agarit with some plugin to the slint, which can check compatibility with browsers we want to support. As you can see, it shows some warnings and specifies in which browsers it doesn't work. Of course, these are only warnings, not errors, to not be annoying while developing. And the configuration is really powerful because in browser list RC, we can specify not only the one version of, for example, Firefox on Chrome, but we can put, for example, last two versions of each browser and not that browser, something like this. So it's, I think it's very good feature. I want to merge this soon. And that's everything I prepared. Any questions? Thank you.